بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعليه وصحبه أجمعين. ثم ما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Brothers and sisters, so we discussed that Iman is the first condition for our success. And we said that Iman is more than Islam. So Iman is where we are actually doing the good action, but we are developing our relationship with our Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're testing the sweetness of that relationship. So we do things willingly out of love of our Creator. And we know the famous hadith where Jibreel alayhi salam, he came to the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked him about Iman. The Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam responded, Iman is believing in Allah, His angels, His books, His messengers, the last day, Day of Judgment, and Qadr. Okay? Qadr, which is predestination, which is fate. So if we think about this, these are the unseen, right? So we haven't seen Allah, we haven't seen His angels, we haven't seen His messengers. So this is a characteristic of Iman. This is the way that the Prophet ﷺ defined Iman, that we need to have very strong belief in the unseen, okay? This is a key characteristic of Iman. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions at the start of Surah Baqarah, He mentions that this Quran is guidance for those that have taqwa, okay? And the first characteristic of those people is الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. They believe in the unseen. So this is a very, very key characteristic to have, the belief in the unseen. So we should just check ourselves. How is our belief in the unseen? You know, do we think about the Day of Judgment? The fact that we will one day be judged for our actions. Consequently, do we think about our death often? You know, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if He was visible in the sky, if we just walked and we looked up and we could see Allah, the world would be a different place, right? Because people would say, oh look, Allah's watching us. The thing is, Allah is still watching us, okay? The test is that we can't see Him. So this is a test, okay? This is why belief in the unseen is key. This is very important. Now what is the primary fruit of Iman, okay? What is a way in which we can check for ourselves, test for ourselves how our Iman is? The scholars will tell you that it is being at peace with Allah, no matter what the situation. So whatever you're going through, you realize everything is a test from Allah, everything is a gift from Allah. So for example, if Allah took away our house, our car, our wealth, even our children, our spouse, we would be content with His decision ultimately, because these were all gifts given to us from Allah. They were never ours, only being returned to the rightful owner, to Allah. So subhanAllah, this is something which we can check for ourselves, and how would we be in this situation? And we know the hadith from the Prophet ﷺ, where he said, how wonderful this is the situation for a mu'min, okay, for a mu'min, not a Muslim, not one who has Islam, okay, but one who has Iman, mu'min. All his affairs are good, okay, when good happens to him, he is grateful to Allah, that is good for him. When something which seems bad happens to him, he remains patient, and that is good for him as well. And this is only the case for someone who is a mu'min, okay? So again, this is a good test for ourselves, okay? Just to check ourselves and see, okay, how are we in this situation? Okay, so a believer, someone with Iman, is always content in any situation. So the thing is, you know, why do people go after one house and the next house, and one car and the next car, or one fashion and the next fashion, or one movie to the next movie? It's to try and get peace and contentment in their heart, to fulfill their desires, okay? To get the ultimate peace in their heart, to make their heart at rest. But no, what does Allah say? أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَتْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. Okay? It is only by the remembrance of Allah that hearts find rest. So, you know, you won't have any loss if your ultimate pleasure is in remembering Allah. Okay? So this is really important, okay? Iman is the first of the four conditions for our success. And in fact, if we have Iman, the other conditions, the Amal Salihat, Tawasaw Bilhaq, Tawasaw Bilsabr, the doing of the good actions, advising each other to the truth, advising each other to be patient, to persevere, they will naturally follow, okay? There will be a natural consequence if we have Iman. Allah says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Okay, surely, truly, already are successful. أَفْلَحَ is the past tense, successful. Allah is saying, the mu'minun, those who have Iman, they were already successful. So why were they already successful? Because if you have Iman, then the other conditions that we need to be successful, the other three conditions, they will naturally follow. You know, sure, different people will find different challenges and fulfilling the conditions. Some people may find it more difficult to advise each other to the truth, but that is just everybody's test. But the point is that if we have Iman, then we are already on the road to success. So how can we get onto this path of Iman? How can we actually develop our Iman? How can we get onto the path of success? We will, inshallah, discuss this in the next part. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك.